How long does Dihexa take to work? Well, it's a good question, and I'm going to answer it in this video, and I'll show you how you can accelerate the speed in which you notice a difference with Dihexa. I'll also show you how you can get a baseline so you can find out if Dihexa is right for you. And by the end of this video, you're going to be an expert on Dihexa. So let's jump into Dihexa, one of my favorite peptides. So Dihexa is interesting because when you start taking it, a lot of people have noticeable effects within the first couple of days, even some people the first day. And just like any other peptide, one thing you'll notice is that everything builds on momentum. So health doesn't happen overnight, neither does disease in most cases. And so as you start activating this pathway, so it works on the angiotensin pathway, as you start activating that pathway, you just notice that you feel a little sharper. And it's subtle in the beginning. And I'm very susceptible to placebo, as are most humans. But even with this one, if you don't actually know what you're taking, there's some interesting data that shows that Dihexa does help with what's called neurogenesis. So you get this new formation of neurons. It also helps with greater synaptic activity, so you're going to have better activity in the brain. So what do you want to look for? Okay, so first of all, just do a quick check. You know, close your eyes, breathe a few times, and see how your brain feels. Do you have any ringing in your ears? Do you have any kind of sensation in your brain where it feels heavy? Do you have any sensation in your stomach or your chest where it feels heavy? If you do have that heaviness, go ahead and breathe through it. Get the energy moving. And now what I want you to do is grab a book and just read a chapter of the book. Now pause the video. And if you forget to come back to this video, I'm fine with that. But when you do come back after you read the chapter, then think about what you read and how was that data? How was it processed? Were you excited as you read it? Maybe you read a fiction book. And so do you remember the characters' names? Just give yourself a quick test. And I know you're like, well, Regan, this is hardly an objective test. It's actually more objective than you may think, because think about, okay, what are the details you remember in that chapter of whatever book it is that you just read? If it was a nonfiction, do you remember some of the technical details? Is it fuzzy? Was it hard for you to concentrate for that long? These are really important things because it's rare these days that someone can actually pick up a book and read a whole chapter and stay focused on it. And if you can do that, then you know maybe Dihexa will just give you a little bit of an edge. But if you notice that you're struggling to recall the information from that one simple chapter in a book, then I think Dihexa will be a really good way for you to see if this peptide might be right for your brain. And so what you're going to do is use Dihexa for 30 days, and you're going to set a reminder in your phone. So you're going to talk into your phone, set a reminder for 30 days from now, read a chapter in the book, and grade yourself. So you can just give yourself a grade score on a scale of 1 to 10, 10 being ideal. You're able to read really quickly. You're able to comprehend what you're reading. You could remember the details. Or if you're a one, it's like, I couldn't even make it through a page. My brain was all over the map. You know, so give yourself a grade there. All right, and then if you want, you know, ask questions, plug in your score in the chat box. Love to hear how your brain's doing before and after. Okay, so Dihexa, as you're looking at the onset of this, a lot of people who use Dihexa, what they've reported is better cognitive clarity. One of our clients, he said it's the difference between lights on, lights off. It was like a switch turned on in his brain. And for him, that happened within 3 days. And he was shocked. And so other people, it may take, you know, 2 or 3 weeks before they get that pathway built up enough to where you have the momentum where you actually have better output in your brain. So one of the things that's interesting about our bodies is our bodies are full of electrical energy, and our bodies have all this requirement and demand of electrical energy, specifically in the brain. Your brain consumes about 20% of the electrical energy of the body when you're awake. And then when we sleep, our brain actually utilizes 25% of the electrical energy. And if you've got really good electrical conductivity in the brain, then your brain can adapt much easier. You have more stress resilience, you have more power output, you can focus on complex subjects and really master those subjects quickly. But what we've seen in hundreds of brain scans that we've done is we see that most people, They push themselves too hard cognitively, and then they don't have recovery times, and they lose interest in the subject that they, you know, maybe it's your work, maybe you're an engineer and you're just like, you just don't really have that same fascination with the problems that you're working on, and you burn yourself out. And we can see it in the electrical energy of the brain. But what Dihexa does is it turns on the light switch. So anytime you have these neurotransmitters that are communicating, and if you see the image of it, it's really pretty because it's like your neurons come out and they have these like almost like this, it's called the synaptic cleft, but the synaptic cleft just shoots over serotonin, dopamine, acetylcholine, GABA, all these cool little molecules that can elevate our mood, it can help us with focus, help us with clarity. And when you've got really good circulation there, that's where you can be dynamic throughout the day. You can be, serious and you can be very focused. You can also be more jovial and happy and lighthearted. And it's just based on what mood you want your brain to be in. But the electrical brain waves can be measured, and you can see that when people are burned out, their delta and their theta waves are going to be higher in the day, which is you want those at night when you're sleeping. And their alpha, their beta, their gamma, those are suppressed. We've seen them in the single digits for people who are really burned out. So for those of you who are like, I want to get this test, well, just go to agelessfuture.com, schedule a health span assessment, and we'll figure out a way that we can get this test done for you. Takes 5 minutes, and it's a phenomenal readout. I've got a lot of videos on that. So Dihexa, okay, so how are you going to notice the difference and how can you accelerate it? So let's talk about this. So first of all, Dihexa is going to help with this neuroplasticity. And one thing that you can do if you want to accelerate the progress, now talk to your doctor about this, but you can combine nicotine with Dihexa because it's working on the angiotensin pathway, so you can ramp up the volume. What I like is Lucy gum, and it's these 2 milligram gums, a piece of gum. And so you chew it just a couple of times. You don't want to get this big surge of nicotine. You just want a microdose, just a little tiny bit, and it will activate that pathway. And so you're kickstarting this whole process of re-engaging the brain and regeneration. The other thing that we do to accelerate is we have patients do intranasal stem cells. And intranasal stem cells is just a nasal mist where we use stem cells from an umbilical cord tissue. And those neuropeptides can migrate up through the blood-brain barrier and they can calm down the inflammatory cycles in the brain. It also helps promote neurogenesis. And then you'll see an enormous benefit as far as your ability to focus and mental clarity. I've talked a lot about this in other videos, but this is one of the main treatments that I did when I started working on my brain over a decade ago. And it took me from being kind of a wild, out of control ADHD, where my brain was, you know, pulling me in so many different directions, to being able to focus and to be able to write and read and comprehend things in a much clearer way. So the third thing that you can do to stimulate it and to activate Dihexa even more is you want to focus on your nutrition. Now, nutrition, we talk a lot about these brain foods. Great resource is Jim Quick, and he's got such a phenomenal memory. I mean, you can give him all these numbers in a row and he can go back and restate the numbers, the letters. He is a wizard, but he wasn't always like that. He went through his own brain trauma and had a learning disability, but he actually learned how to use his brain and optimize it. But he talks about some of the core foods. One of the foods that Jim Quick loves is these nice fatty acids from healthy fish like salmon. He also loves blueberries, and these foods can actually help feed your brain. I'm a big fan of sardines personally. Not necessarily, I don't really like the way they taste. They're fine, but I do love the benefits of the fish, the smaller fish like sardines, mackerel, anchovy. So good for your brain, and they don't have the heavy metals. So these are some things you can do nutritionally to accelerate the progress. And then the fourth and final thing that you want to do to activate Dihexa is high intensity interval trainings. So anytime you do this high intensity workouts, and you don't want to do it every day, but even if you do 2 a week or even 1 a week, what you'll notice is your levels of growth hormone increase dramatically. In some cases, it depends on the person, but you can increase your growth hormone almost 200% just by doing a high intensity interval training. And what that means is where you do an exercise where you go to maximum capacity and you do that for short bursts and then you let your body recover and then you repeat it. So a couple days ago, I was doing all out sprints. One of my goals every year, I have a new birthday and I set new goals. This year, my goal is to be able to sprint as fast as I could when I was in high school. So I ran track in high school and I was very fast at the 40-yard dash, had the leading time in my school. And I'm like, well, I could run fast back then. Why can't I do that today? So I did 10 sprints all out for about 40 yards. And then I let my body recover and I did that 10 times. And I can tell you, it woke up my brain in brand new ways. And that's the same thing that can happen to you, because when growth hormone gets activated through the pathway IGF-1, it unlocks the gene that allows for more BDNF, which is what makes our brains more plastic and creative. And not plastic as in like you're getting a bunch of plastics water bottles, but like plastic as in it can heal and be remolded. So those four things. Number one, try a little bit of nicotine and just do that in the beginning as a little jump start. Number two is intranasal stem cells. Can be incredibly helpful. Number three is eat foods. Think fatty acids, olive oil, fish, anchovies, sardines, and blueberries. And then number four is high intensity interval trainings. And what you'll experience is you'll see the benefits of Dihexa much quicker. You'll get the cognitive clarity you're looking for. You'll have that direction, the purpose that you're looking for. And you'll start feeling like yourself again. Now, for those of you who are really excited to use Dihexa, then you'll want to go to my next video on exactly how to use Dihexa, and I'll see you there.